Namaste and welcome to the Jyotishi YouTube channel. Tomorrow being Ugadi and day after being Vishu, we are going to discuss on the importance of sun moving into Aries, right? This is also the month of Chaitra and how Chaitra can essentially work on your life and what it is related to the fire element. So that is what we are going to talk about. Tomorrow being the Hindu New Year,
yes,
which is also known as Ugadi or Guri Parva,
yes,
and it's also the start of Chaitra Navratri tomorrow,
yes,
right?
Yes.
So what is the significance of Ugadi? Why do we celebrate it tomorrow and not on the 31st of December?
Yes, so actually in Hindu belief, the new year starts tomorrow, either the 13th or the 14th of April. So it has a beautiful signification starting from Chaitra month. So Chaitra is, we have 12 months, and Chaitra, as per Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, among the months, I am Chaitra. So it is a very, very auspicious month from that perspective. So there are about 30 festivals in this particular month in this country. And so you would note that the ninth day of the Chaitra is when Lord Rama was born. So you have Chaitra Navratri. Then you have Lord Hanuman's birth as well in this particular month. And Lord Mahavir also was born in this month. So it's a very auspicious kind of a month from that perspective. And from an astrological point of view, what you figure out is we follow the solar and the lunisolar calendar type, right? So in many of the states, the festivals are based on tropical, the movement of the sun,
right,
entering into Aries.
Right.
And when sun enters 0 degree Aries, it is primarily mostly in the 13th or the 14th,
right,
of that particular month.
Right.
And in most of the months, the first day is considered, the first day after the Amavasya is considered the Pratipad, right?
Right.
So from a Tithi perspective, the first day is, so for example, celebrated as Ugadi in Karnataka. In Andhra Pradesh, it is Yugadi.
Right.
And then you have Gudi Padwa in Maharashtra.
Maharashtra.
And then you have Choti Chand in...
Right.
What do you call, North India kind of a thing, then you have Vaisakhi and those.
Yeah.
So there are various names available. Primarily, it's based on, festivals were based on the movements of the planets actually.
Mm.
And here in this case, sun enters Aries, and it is also the first day.
Okay.
First day of the Tithi, which is called Pratipat after Amavasya.
Okay.
So from solar calendar, we have another state called Kerala where they celebrate Vishu. So it is primarily the movement of the sun at 0 degrees,
right,
but the Tithi may not be the Pratipada, it is the second Tithi. So
okay,
it usually comes plus or minus one or two days kind of.
Right.
So that is primarily the significance of this particular
Okay.
Day. So it is believed that Lord Brahma created the universe on this particular Pratipada. So the entire set of the concept of time, concept of movement of sun and moon, and the various planets were created. So the entire process of creation started on this particular day, and that is why, you know, Bhagavad Gita stresses, Krishna stresses the importance of this particular month,
right,
Chaitra as a whole,
right.
And then he says, you know, like for example, among the, you know, festivals, the among the seasons, I am Chaitra kind of a thing. So that is why it is so sort of very important and auspicious kind of a thing.
Right. So now there are multiple ways this festival is celebrated,
yes,
right? Like for example in South India, so this festival also has a great significance to Ayurveda. If you look at it, we eat all 6 days on this particular festival.
Yes.
Sweet jaggery, neem is bitter, right?
Yes.
Then you have puli, right? All the 6 days are eaten on this particular day.
Yes. So it is directly correlated to the Navagrahas.
Okay.
It is directly correlated to the Navarasas. It is also correlated to the Nayan, the flavors that comes up in your life. And then, so for example, in Karnataka, in Ugadi, you have the banana leaf, the neem leaves.
Yes.
And so it is all significations of different tastes and flavors that spice up your life kind of a
thing.
So it the flavors, the emotions, it is symbolic from that perspective. Yes. Right. It is symbolic from that perspective.
Right. So what should, apart from generally celebrating,
yes.
What is good to do tomorrow? Like what is most significant to do tomorrow?
Yes, so creation is supposed to have started, right? Okay. So Brahma created this entire universe, and it is also believed that, the most auspicious birth, from a Hindu perspective,
right.
It is Jai Shri Ram, Lord Shri Ram's birth happened in this particular time
month.
Frame.
Oh.
So it is sort of believed that reading Ramayana, reading talking about Rama's stories and different khandas and those kind of things, if it is any small hymns towards Lord Rama and those kind of things, very very auspicious in this particular month. So you would notice many cultures in this region, they pray to Lord Rama, they talk about Ramayana, they talk about Ramakatha and those kind of things. So it is very auspicious from that perspective, the entire framework.
Sun in Aries is in exaltation,
yes,
right?
Yes.
So any special significance of that for
yes.
this particular month?
The best component of sun, which is the soul, it emerges out during April. So it is in around 10 to 14 degrees, that is the area where sun gets exalted, right? So, and it is directly correlated to the Suryavanshi, Lord Shri Ram.
Right.
And when the sun is exalted, and if the ego is sort of low kind of a thing, you are becoming a Mahapurusha, you are becoming a Dharma Purusha kind of a thing, you are becoming Shri Ram. So that is where the clear differentiation between Lord Shri Ram's representation in this universe is Suryavanshi,
right.
A person who came from the Sun dynasty, and a person who is Mariyada Purushottam, who is sort of the best human being,
complete human being,
who
someone can look up to.
Yes. So that is what the signification when sun is exalted. You emerge out of your soul, and, or you merge with your soul, kind of a thing, and then you lower your ego to the maximum extent, and then emerge out to be a Manava Sreshta. So he is also called Manava Sreshta, so Sreshta among Manavas. So the best human being, kind of a thing. So that is what you should try and evolve into in this particular time.
Any particular chants that one should do for this particular?
Yeah. So the best chant for Lord Rama is Rama, Rama, Rama.
Okay.
Just three times.
Okay.
So there is a story, right? So where Lord Shiva, says that if you chant Rama, 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 so the entire shloka goes like this: Shri Rama, Rama, Rameti, Rame, Rame, Manorame, Sahasrama, Tattulyam, Rama, Nam, Varanam. So if you chant Rama, Rama, Rama three times, it is like chanting the entire Vishnu Sahasrama.
Okay.
So it is that powerful, and anybody who chants these three continuously, that's Rama, 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 so in the multiples of three,
right.
It is supposed to be very, very auspicious, and Ra actually from a phonetics perspective, it symbolizes sun.
Okay.
So you have your chakras, right?
Right.
So we are sort of slightly deviating. Lam, Vam, Ram, Yam. So these are chakras related to various chakras in your body, right from Muladhara to Sahasrara. And Ra here symbolizes the fire element.
Okay.
Fire is related to the Surya dynasty. And so Ram is a very auspicious thing from that perspective, where that chant sort of directly connects you to fire element and directly to the Suryavanshi Lord Ram.
Okay.
So from that perspective, Rama, Rama, Rama is a fantastic chant to do in this particular
this particular month,
entire continuous month.
So every state has a particular significance in celebrating this. For example, in Kerala it is Vishu, right? In Tamil it is Puthandu. In Andhra it is celebrated as Ugadi, right? Then there is Gudi Parva in Maharashtra. Then there's Baisakhi in Punjab. So every festival, essentially every state has this festival being celebrated differently. There's also a lot of celebration in terms of the sort of food that is prepared. Like every state has its own special delicacy And like, for example, in Karnataka and Andhra, people have neem leaves and jaggery to start their day, which also signifies that, you know, life is a mixture of both good and bad, right? Neem signifies bitterness and jaggery signifies the sweetness in life. So the significance of this is one has to consume both and then move on in life. So that is what is the significance of eating neem and jaggery on this particular day. And like Anand mentioned, it is good to chant the Ram mantra, which increases and directly connects us to the fire element. If you would like to know more, do leave us a comment below on what you would like to know, and we'll make a video on that. Thank you for watching the Jyotishi YouTube channel.